I am Anders Hagstrom with The Daily Caller, and with me today is YAF spokesman Spencer Brown. And there has been a pretty big video, obviously it's up to something like 4 million views, of a person at UVA, a student there, a female student there, at the Multicultural Student Center. She gets up and gives this whole speech about how it's one of the only places on campus that people of color are allowed to be, essentially. She says that there are no spaces on campus for people of color and that white people should not be allowed in the Multicultural Student Center.
And frankly, there's just too many white people in here, and this is a space for people of color. So just be really cognizant of the space that you're taking up, because it does make some of us POCs uncomfortable when we see too many white people in here. It's only been open for 4 days, and frankly, there's the whole university for a lot of y'all to be at, and there's very few spaces for us.
Is that true?
Not at all. I mean, it's University of Virginia. That campus, like every other campus in the country, is prohibited from classifying certain areas for people based on the color of their skin, obviously, as is the rest of the country nowadays, and rightfully and thankfully so. And so for her to be claiming that there's only one student center on campus where she is allowed is just not true.
Mm-hmm. And so what has been the reaction to this? Because obviously on Twitter there's a pretty big backlash, but what about from the more lefty people? Like, what has been the reaction there?
Well, they are saying that Young America's Foundation should apologize for releasing this video, which we didn't shoot, we didn't record. Mm-hmm. We simply came across it on Twitter and thought this is a perfect example of what's wrong with higher education today and all this leftist, intersectional, critical race theory nonsense that students are getting. And so we reposted it, and it took off, you know, millions of views later, and everybody's saying this is a problem, and now they're blaming us that people are reacting badly to what this student said.
Mm-hmm. And because I think that's an interesting point, because typically these videos are really contentiously shot. Like someone is getting up in someone's face, they pull out a phone to kind of defend themselves almost, and that's how most of these videos happen. But this is a totally different situation. If you actually like trace the video back down to its origin on Twitter, it is a friend of the person who is speaking, who is giving this essentially racist speech, who's filming. She puts down her phone to clap for her friend at the end of the speech, and it's like they thought that they would be hailed as heroes for this speech. What do you think that speaks to about the culture of colleges in America today, that they would actually think that this is a good thing?
Well, I think it shows how much of a bubble these campuses are, where they think, I'm going to be heroic and tell all these white people they're not welcome here in this multicultural student center that's open to all students. The website for the school says that it's a place to hang out and use computers and study for anyone. And so I think they thought they were going to be, you know, like you said, hailed as heroes for standing up and saying no more white people in our multicultural student center. And obviously, when the rubber met the road of the real world, they realized that's not something, this basically segregationist racism is not something that flies in the rest of the world, or the rest of America, at least.
Yeah. What has been the response from the college? Have they acknowledged this incident at all?
Well, it was kind of awkward, because they did release sort of a statement from, I believe it was the president of the university, that was just addressing the fact and affirming, I believe was the word that they used, that all student centers are open to all students, and they mentioned this multicultural student center, and then I think a couple of the other student centers, sort of these special interest leftist group centers that they have. But they didn't say anything about whether the University of Virginia would tolerate this kind of racist behavior. Obviously, if the situation were reversed and a white student had gone somewhere and said, the black people in here are making us uncomfortable, you need to leave, we know what happens, because anytime something like that is alleged, and oftentimes, unfortunately, it's a fake, you know, hate crime hoax on these campuses, we see them bring out, you know, mandatory sensitivity training for all students. The university will release a response talking about how, you know, we commit to do better and we'll redouble our efforts for diversity. But in this case, their response didn't really actually address what was said or what happened. And that's why atmospheres like this continue to fester on campuses, because administrators never do anything about it.
Mm-hmm. So is that why, because obviously working for YAF, you run into these situations almost on a weekly basis. Like, it happens all the time. You see these videos of radical students on campus, but why does it keep happening? Like, what about it, about our college institutions right now is fostering this ideology?
Well, part of it, like I said, is just administrators don't do anything to hold the left accountable when they do stuff like this, but also it's just day in and day out what they're being taught in the classroom. You know, our report every year on what's being taught at these supposedly prestigious institutions shows how critical race theory and intersectionality are just sort of their theories, but they're taught as fact at these universities. And so what we see is that makes everybody believe that they're a victim. that anybody who looks different from them or maybe has more in life is oppressing them individually. And so they feel that it's okay to run around saying white people can't sit here or be in the student center. And arguably, the people in that student center were people who would consider themselves to be allies of this student who's on video. And that's another trend that we've seen where these marginalized groups, as they call themselves, even though they have more opportunity than any generation before them, run around. And now they're saying they don't want allies. They don't want anyone to advocate for them or anything like that. And we see on campuses across the country where black student union sort of organizations will actually advocate and push for completely segregated housing for themselves. So they're just continuing to sort of segment themselves off. And that's sort of the divisive nature of these leftist ideologies, is you just continually pull back and back and back until there's no sort of crossover, there's no room for understanding or growth or anything like that.
Do you think that'll eventually lead to this ideology petering out? Like if you say, hey, we don't want any allies, well, that's a great way to not have any allies. So do you see this continuing to ratchet up, or do you think it'll reach a sort of peak moment, maybe we're at it now, and then it starts falling back down again?
You know, I don't think we've seen the peak yet. Just I've been doing this, I've been working with YAF for about 4.5 years now, and it seems like every semester, especially since the election of President Trump, the left has ratcheted up both the frequency of their intolerance and also sort of the intensity of it. So we see sometimes more violent opposition and things like that. And I think, you know, until there's some sort of actual financial repercussions for these universities, and there have been a few cases, the University of Missouri is a great one where they really had enrollment fall off because students didn't want to go to a school where it's just absolute mayhem every day. And so I think unless there's more consequences like that are sort of real world and not just negative media attention all the time, I don't see it really changing. And these students, again, are never punished, and so they don't see any sort of obstacle to them continuing to act like this.
Do you think that the government has a role in creating real-world consequences, as you call them?
Well, it was interesting. About a year ago, actually, at CPAC 2019, President Trump announced that he was signing that executive order requiring public universities, or actually any university that takes federal funding, to support the First Amendment rights of all students. We haven't seen that used yet against a university. I know the different agencies who are tasked with running that have to kind of put teeth on this executive order for how they'll enforce it. But I do think instances like this might be a case for that, because University of Virginia is a public institution. They can't be running around allowing students to kick other students out of places based on the color of their skin. That you can't do that. That is against laws and should be against university policy if it isn't already. But I think, you know, that again goes to the financial aspect of it. If they lose research dollars or things like that, I think that would force administrators to actually do something about it. But right now, I think sort of as a result of how the left acts versus how conservatives act, administrators are much more willing to sort of bow or be silent when it's about the left, because the leftist students are the ones who will go and sit in a president's office and call for their resignation, whereas conservatives, we're used to this. This has been the norm for, you know, YAF's been around 50 years. We've seen this since the beginning. And so conservatives don't, you know, ride in the streets or anything on their campus when we don't get our way.
Yep. They don't tend to use the heckler's veto, at least on college campuses.
Right.
All right. Well, Spencer, thanks so much for coming on. We appreciate it.
Thank you.